In this video, we're going to cover the warning signs that indicate the likelihood of a relationship becoming violent, as well as the risk factors for intimate partner homicide. There's nothing more heartbreaking or soul-destroying than fearing someone you love, as it creates a conflict between two instincts that should never compete: your natural instinct to want to stay in a safe environment and your instinct to flee when you sense danger. Your partner most likely appeared to be the sweetest, most loving guy you'd ever met, yet now you're consumed with fear and self-doubt. Did you know that most women in abusive relationships feel so confused they don't even know it's abuse? Because an abuser's most manipulative tactic is convincing his partner that he acts the way he does because of her or because of his love for her. So let's be clear on two things. You're not the cause of his behavior, nor is his love for you the reason he's abusive. If you've noticed the abuse is escalating, no doubt you've wondered, how do I know if he'll become violent? And if you have asked that question, it means a potential for violence is already there, because one of the many warning signs for violence is a woman having intuitive feelings she's at risk. Women know when something feels off, but they don't always act on their intuition because they often feel irrational for thinking they're in danger, which is something no other living species on the planet does. But since an abusive relationship can have you questioning your sanity, it can feel like you're going crazy. Countless women grapple with the mixed signals they receive from their partners. He says he loves me, but I wake up every day walking on eggshells. The mind games are crazy making, and his rules change on the fly. Everything I do seems to make him angry, and he's starting to really scare me. What you're about to hear is there are many warning signs for relationship violence, just as there are known risk factors for intimate partner homicide. So let's start with the warning signs that might occur early on in the relationship. Number one is you intuitively felt you were at risk. Even in the honeymoon phase, there were things he did or said that set off alarm bells. Yet given every question you had about his behavior was being responded to with, "because I love you," you might have thought you were overreacting. Two is the pace of the relationship. Your relationship moved towards commitment extremely fast. For example, you become a couple very quickly, or he wants to move in together, or proposes marriage in a hurry. He says he's your soulmate, so why wait? Three is he makes unrealistic fantasy statements about never-ending love. For example, "we're meant to be together forever. You're the woman of my dreams. It's God's will that we're together. I've never felt this way about anyone before. We'll never be apart." These statements should, and probably already did, alert you. They might have made you feel like he was your soulmate, yet something about his intensity made you feel uneasy. Four is he constantly needs to check on you. "Where are you? What are you up to? Who are you with? Why haven't you replied to my text?" When you're under the spell of his charm in the early stages, his checking on you no doubt felt flattering, but be assured, the constant tracking of your movements is nothing to do with love. These are the early warning signs of control. Five is he frequently displays jealousy. The signs of jealousy will usually be more contained in the early stages, but they will be there. He may show levels of agitation when you spend time with other people or on other things outside of the relationship. Six is he shows signs of possessiveness. Just like jealousy, the signs might be more subtle in the early stages. They might be in the form of words like, "you're mine." But let me assure you, there won't be anything cute about those words further down the track. "You're mine" equals my rightfully owned property. Seven is he treats the word "no" as the beginning of a negotiation rather than the end of a discussion. He refuses to hear your "no" as he sees it as a rejection. Eventually, almost everything you do that doesn't give him control will result in increased hostility. Eight is he isolates you from friends, family, or co-workers. The early attempts at isolating you are usually deceitfully disguised. Here are some examples of the manipulation he might use. "I feel like your friend's jealous and doesn't want us to be together." Or, "that friend isn't good for you and I've got your best interests at heart. Your family's trying to destroy us." Or, "I'm just trying to protect our relationship." Nine is he convinces you to reduce your normal activities outside of the relationship. He might start with covert manipulation, such as, "Why do you have to go do X tonight? Don't you want to be with me?" Or more blatant manipulation. For example, "you wouldn't be going to X event if you really loved me." There's often an extreme level of intensity in the way he pursues the relationship in the early stages. a tactic that's often referred to as love bombing, which in itself is another form of control. So now that we've covered the early warning signs on the likelihood of a relationship becoming violent, let's look at the warning signs that indicate your life might be in danger. Although the signs of control may have been subtle at first, escalating levels of control equal an increased risk to your safety. You might be intuitively feeling you're at risk, even if you can't quite put your finger on why. Some women have described things as simple as the way he looked at them. For example, sometimes a hair would stand up on the back of my neck from the way he looked at me. I just don't know how to describe it. These type of gut instincts should never be minimized, as women are more likely to underestimate rather than overestimate the level of danger they're in. The warning signs mentioned earlier might have dramatically escalated. For example, his unrealistic statements of never-ending love might now include threats about never leaving or that he can't live without you. His constant checking might include removing your right to privacy to the point of checking your phone, monitoring your calls, your emails, your search history, and demanding passwords to your social networks. His jealousy will likely have escalated to outrage towards anything that takes your attention away from him or the relationship. For example, eye contact with another male can cause fits of rage, and friendships with the opposite sex might be completely banned. No matter what you do, you're accused of cheating on him. His possessiveness might have escalated to needing to know where you are at all times, which causes you to feel increasingly anxious if you notice a missed call. His level of entitlement makes it clear that he owns you, that you're his property, and if he can't have you, no one can. His refusal to hear the word no might escalate to commanding complete obedience to every request, including sex, and any refusal to comply results in punishment, withdrawal of love, or violence. Isolation from friends and family might have increased and could involve moving to a location where you don't have a support network. Activities outside of the relationship, including work, might be restricted or completely banned. These are just some of the warning signs that you're in a dangerous relationship, whether it's physically violent yet or not. But the most important part to pay attention to is your own intuition and internal warning system. You don't need concrete evidence that you're at risk. If you feel afraid, there's a good reason you're feeling this way. If this is you or someone you know, please contact your National Domestic Violence Hotline for assistance with safety planning. You don't need to face this alone. In the final part of this video, we're going to look at the risk factors for intimate partner homicide. As well as the escalating warning signs already mentioned, these are the signs that showed in many cases of women who were killed or almost killed by a current or former intimate partner. This information comes from the extensive research done by Dr. Jacqueline Campbell, who specialises in intimate partner danger assessment, as well as Gavin DeBecker, who's a risk assessment specialist. So let's go through the factors that increase a woman's level of risk. Physical violence increasing in severity and frequency. A partner who's attempted to choke, which is essentially broadcasting his ability to kill. A woman believing her partner's capable of killing her, which we mentioned earlier. Her violent partner has access to or owns a gun. The woman's received previous injuries that could have led to death. He was violent towards her during pregnancy. He controls all of her activities. He's threatened her with a weapon. Her partner's forced her to have sex. He uses street drugs or is a problem drinker. It's important to note that while drugs and alcohol are not the cause of his violence, they do increase her risk of fatal injury. Her partner's threatened or tried to commit suicide, which means there's an increased risk for homicide-suicide. Her partner is or becomes unemployed, resulting in him feeling worthless. He's violently jealous, for example, if I can't have you, no one can. The woman has a child or children from a previous relationship that aren't his. Her partner's been violent towards her children, his stepchildren. He's violent outside of the home or destroys her property, particularly items of a symbolic nature. He's previously been arrested for relationship violence. Her partner stalks her or has others report on her activities. The woman stating she's leaving or planning to leave a violent or controlling relationship. The first 3 months after she leaves and the entire first year after leaving. Whilst leaving and shortly after leaving are extremely high risk periods, it doesn't end there. The risk can re-escalate anytime he experiences a life event or receives proof that he no longer has control over the relationship. For example, she goes to court or he finds out she has a new partner, which is a signal she's not coming back. It's important to note that not all women who were killed or almost killed experience violence in their relationship. In these cases, the level of stalking was often overlooked as a potentially lethal warning sign. So the degree to which he tracks and controls her activities directly correlates with an increased level of risk, despite the fact that there might not have been any physical violence in the relationship. The UK now recognises coercive control as a serious crime, and more lives will be saved when other countries follow their example. Not all of the warning signs mentioned will be present in every situation, but in a controlling or violent relationship where one of them is, a person's life may be in danger. If this is you or someone you know, please contact your National Domestic Violence Hotline for assistance with safety planning. If you have access to a computer from a safe place that he can't monitor, here are two websites that can help determine the level of risk an abuse survivor has of being killed by her intimate partner. The Danger Assessment Instrument, which can be found at dangerassessment.org, and the Mosaic Threat Assessment Method, which can be found at mosaicmethod.com, which can be used to assess the risk for both females and males. Acknowledging that a person you care for might fatally harm you is a lot to grasp, especially when they say they love you. Most people are unaware of warning signs for the likelihood of a partner becoming violent or lethal, so this information has been put together to help women understand that abusive relationships can become violent. With 1 in 3 women experiencing relationship violence at some stage during their lives, someone you know needs this information. The more we spread awareness of the early warning signs, the more we can help before it's too late.